Let's look at the next section, students. This section contains two matrix match the column type questions. Entries given in column 1 have to be matched with entries given in column 2. For every entry in column 1, there may be one or more than one option which is matching with it in column 2. So let's start with question number 36, students. So column 1 contains the carbohydrates which undergoes hydrolysis in acidic medium and leads to the formation of smaller carbohydrates. Column 2 contains the properties of the carbohydrates X or their hydrolysis products. So let us start with the first entry given in column A, students. So consider the hydrolysis of the given carbohydrates. Okay, so sucrose, it is allowed to undergo hydrolysis in the acidic medium. Let us look at option P now. Option P, it says that X is a reducing sugar. So this will not be matched with A, students. Sucrose, it is non-reducing. So P will not be a match, whereas Q will be matched. So A will be matched with Q. Talk about the option R now. It says X has C1-C4 glycosidic linkage between the two monosaccharides. This is not correct, students. X has a C1-C2 linkage. So sucrose has a C1-C2 linkage and not C1-C4 linkage. So R will not be matched with A. If you talk about option S now, monosaccharides obtained by the acidic hydrolysis is or are reducing. So this is correct, students. Sucrose on hydrolysis, it gives glucose and fructose. So both glucose as well as fructose are reducing in nature. So S will be matched. If you talk about option T now, all the monosaccharides obtained by acidic hydrolysis of X are different. So this is also correct, students. Sucrose gives glucose and fructose. So these are different in nature. Okay. So students, T will also be matched with A. Let us look at option B now, students. It is maltose. So if you talk about maltose, students, maltose is a dimer of alpha D glucose. Okay. It has a C1-C4 linkage. Okay. So it will be reducing, students, since the C1 of the other glucose is free. So C1 represents the hemiacetal carbon, students. So it will be reducing in nature. So let us look at the options in column 2 and match them with option B. So option P, it says X is reducing sugar. This will be a match, students. Q will not be a match. If you talk about option R now, option R will be match. It has a C1-C4 linkage, students. So R will be match. If you talk about option S now, monosaccharides obtained by acidic hydrolysis are reducing. So this upon hydrolysis will give us 2 units of alpha D glucose. They are reducing in nature. So S will also be a match. If you talk about option T now, option T will not be matched since the product obtained upon hydrolysis are the same. Okay. So B will be matched with P, R and S only. Let's look at the C option now, students. Lactose. So if you talk about lactose, students, lactose is a dimer of beta D glucose and beta D galactose. There is again a C1-C4 linkage, students. So the C1 of the galactose is free. So this will also be reducing in nature. So let us look at the options which are to be matched. So option P, it says X is a reducing sugar. This is correct, students. It has to be matched. If you talk about Q now, Q will not be a match. If you talk about R, X has C1-C4 glycosidic linkage. This is also going to be a match in this case. If you talk about option S, monosaccharides obtained by acidic hydrolysis are reducing. This is also correct, students. We get glucose and galactose. Both of them are aldoses. So aldoses are reducing in nature. So S will also be a match. If you talk about T now, T will also be a match since we get 2 different products upon the hydrolysis of lactose. So this is the match for option C. Let's look at option D now, students. So we have cellulose. So if we talk about cellulose, so cellulose is a polymer of beta D glucose. Okay. So there are C1-C4 linkages. Okay, so in this case, all the C1 and the C4 are linked. Okay, so all the C1s which contain the hemiacetal carbon, they are involved in the formation of glycosidic bonds. So students, they will be non-reducing in nature. So P will not be a match, whereas Q will be. If you talk about option R now, it has C1-C4 linkages, so R also has to be matched. If you talk about option S now, monosaccharides obtained by acidic hydrolysis are reducing in nature. So cellulose upon acidic hydrolysis, it gives us beta D glucose units, which is a aldohexose. So it is reducing in nature. If you talk about option T now, option T will not be matched since it is a polymer of beta D glucose only. So D will be matched with Q, R, N, S only. So students, we have the correct matching for question number 36. Let's look at the next question now. Let's look at question number 37 now. Match each of the reactions given in column 1 with the type of reactions involved given in column 2. So let us start with the first reaction given in column 1. So this given compound is allowed to react with K2CO3 in ETUH. Students, K2CO3 is a base. It will extract the acidic hydrogen. There is an active methylene group which is present. So the carbon ion generated over here will attack intramolecularly, giving a 1,4 conjugate addition product. So at first the enol will form and then the enol will tautomerize to give us the ketone. So this is the indicated reaction, students. We have discussed the mechanism. Okay, now let us look at the entries given in column 2. So P, it has intramolecular migration of an alkyl group. This will not be matched with option E, students. Let us look at option Q now. It says conjugate addition. So we have seen that there is a 1,4 addition to the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound which is present in this group. So this will have to be matched with option A. Let's talk about option R now, that the product shows geometrical isomerism. So this is correct, students. There will be a possibility of a cis trans isomerism at this carbon. So R will also be matched. Let us look at option S now, elimination through E1CB. So this is not correct, students. There is no elimination through E1CB. If you talk about option T now, nucleophilic addition. So this has to be matched, students. The carbon ion getting generated is a nucleophile and it is getting added to the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So option A has to be matched with Q, R and T. Let's look at option B now. So in option B, we have a pinacol. So pinacol is allowed to react with H2SO4. So it will undergo pinacol-pinacolone reaction as represented in the given reaction. So students, if you look at the entries given in column 2 now, P says intramolecular migration of an alkyl group. So this has to be matched, students. In the pinacol-pinacolone, there will be a migration of the methyl group as indicated, leading to the formation of the trimethyl carbon. Okay, there is a rearrangement in the carbon skeleton in this case. Okay. So P has to be matched. Q will not be matched. R, which says that the product obtained shows geometrical isomerism, this will also not be matched. This given compound cannot show geometrical isomerism. Option S, it says elimination through E1CB. This is also not correct, students. And option T, it says there is nucleophilic addition. So this is also not correct, students. There is no nucleophilic addition happening in this case. So only matching of option B will be with option P. Let us look at the next reaction now. In the next reaction, we have the aldol reaction. So it is a cross aldol reaction in which one of the substrates is aldehyde, whereas the other is a ketone. So the ketone will be used for generation of the carbon ion and the attack will happen on the aldehyde group. So the major product will be obtained as represented in the reaction. Let's talk about the entries given in column 2 now. Option P, it says there is intramolecular migration of an alkyl group. This is not correct, students. P will not be matched. Q will also not be matched. There is no conjugate addition. If you talk about R, product obtained shows geometrical isomerism. So this is correct, students. There is an alkene which is getting formed. So there can be a cis trans isomerism about the given alkene. So R has to be matched with option C, students. If you talk about S now, elimination through E1CB, this is also going to be matched with the aldol reaction, students. So if you talk about the aldol reaction, students, there is first formation of a beta hydroxy ketone. Okay, so in the first step, we would have gotten the beta hydroxy ketone as represented. And next, there is an E1CB reaction happening. So the OH minus is going to extract this hydrogen. Okay, this will leave. So there will be a carbon ion formed, which then attacks intramolecularly to make this OH minus leave. Okay, so there is this E1CB reaction which is happening in the given aldol reaction. Okay, so S will be matched. If you talk about T now, there is nucleophilic addition happening in this case, students. The carbon ion generated from the alpha carbon of the ketone will attack the carbonyl carbon of the aldehyde. Okay, so T also has to be matched. Let's look at the last reaction now. So it contains acetophenone. So in acetophenone, it is allowed to react with NaBH4 in ether. So NaBH4 is a supplier of hydride ions. The hydride ions will attack the carbonyl carbon, leading to the formation of the alcohol, students. So if you look at the entries given in column 2, P will not be a match, Q will also not be a match, R will also not be a match, as the product will be an alcohol. Okay, there is no elimination through E1CB. And if you talk about the last one, only the last one will be matched with this. There is a nucleophilic addition. The hydride ions will attack the carbonyl carbon, showing nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay, so this is the correct matching for question number 37, students.